Hello everyone. I am Vinita Philip, working as Assistant Professor in the Department of Electronics and Telecommunication of AISSMS, Institute of Information Technology, Pune. I welcome you all for my series of videos pertaining to the subject Skill Development for TE-ENTC 2019 pattern. In this video, I would be discussing the blood pressure measurement. So the blood pressure monitoring can be done either by using an automatic digital blood pressure monitor or by using an instrument called sphygmomanometer, which gives manual readings. The device also measures heart rate. The technical specifications of the device include a LED, LCD, digital display, oscillometric method is used for measurement. The pressure measurement range is from 0 to 299 mmHg, and for pulse it is 40 to 180 beats per minute. The accuracy for pressure is plus minus 3 mmHg, and for pulse is plus minus 5% of display reading. Fuzzy logic control by electric pump is used for inflation, and for deflation automatic pressure release valve. The systolic blood pressure is 120 to 129 mmHg and diastolic blood pressure is less than 80 mmHg. Here is a block diagram of such a digital blood pressure monitoring device, which uses an inflatable air bladder cuff, a battery-powered air pump, and a pressure sensor for sensing arterial wall vibrations to measure blood pressure in an artery. This is known as oscillometric method. With an oscillatory device, a cuff is inflated over the upper arm or wrist. Fuzzy logic is used to decide how much the cuff should be inflated to reach a pressure about 20 mmHg above systolic pressure for any individual. When the cuff is fully inflated to this pressure, no blood flow occurs through the artery. This pressure is then gradually released using a digitally controlled solenoid valve until the moment that the blood begins to flow through the artery. So as the cuff is deflated below the systolic pressure, the reducing pressure exerted on the artery allows blood to flow through it and sets up a detectable vibration in the arterial wall. The blood pressure measured by a pressure sensor at this point determines the systolic pressure. Pulse rate is also sensed at this time. The measurement takes when the blood flow is no longer restricted and determines the diastolic pressure. This complete measurement cycle is controlled automatically by the microcontroller. When the cuff pressure falls below the patient's diastolic pressure, blood flows smoothly through the artery in the usual pulses without any vibration being set up in the wall. Vibrations occur at any point where the cuff pressure is sufficiently high that the blood has to push the arterial wall open in order to flow through the artery. The vibrations are transferred from the arterial wall through the air inside the cuff into a transducer in the monitor that converts the measurements into electrical signal. Thus, the signal from the pressure sensor is conditioned with an instrumentation amplifier before data conversion by ADC. Systolic pressure, diastolic pressure, and pulse rate are then calculated in the digital domain using an algorithm appropriate for the type of monitor and sensor utilized. The resulting systolic, diastolic, and pulse rate measurements are displayed on the LCD. For user interface, most blood pressure monitors employ LCD. A high-end blood pressure monitor may use a color LCD with touch screen to implement advanced user interface. Audible notifications in blood pressure monitors can be provided by simple beepers driven by one or two microcontroller port pins that have PWM capability. More advanced voice announcements can be achieved by adding DAC and an amplified speaker. For connectivity, it is possible to upload data on a computer or a smartphone for further analysis and tracking of measurements over time using USB interface or Bluetooth, or even by using Wi-Fi or cellular wireless networking to upload data to a remote digital health information management system without relying on a computer or a smartphone. So the device mainly consists of the main unit, the arm cuff, and the display. This blood pressure monitoring device requires 4 AA batteries for it to be operated. The operation of the device involves 3 simple steps. Apply the arm cuff, turn on the device and sit comfortably, and read the corresponding data from the display screen. Let us now see the demonstration of the operation of the device.
The first step for monitoring the blood pressure using the automatic blood pressure monitor is to insert the air plug into the air jack securely. Step number 2 is to put your arm through the cuff loop. Step number 3 is to close the fabric and fasten firmly. Next step is to press the start-stop button. Please note that it is important to sit correctly while measuring the blood pressure. Sit on a chair with your legs uncrossed and your feet flat on the floor. Sit upright with your back straight. Sit with your back and arm being supported. The arm cuff should be placed on your arm at the same level as that of your heart. This automatic blood pressure monitoring device requires 4 AAA batteries to be operated.
The troubleshooting and maintenance of the device includes certain error messages that are displayed, which are from E1 up to E5 and ER, and their possible causes are as listed in this table. For troubleshooting, these are some of the problems that can be the root cause and their corresponding causes as listed in the table shown. That's all for now. Stay tuned for many such videos on important concepts of the subject skill development. Thank you for watching.